Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. In this video on the CMake series, I would like to talk to you about using libraries, which is, in my opinion, one of CMake's strongest points. What happens when we export a library with CMake is that the library author is going to save a number of information inside of the target, which is the thing that will be used by other projects to use that library. And this mechanism works inside of the same project or between different projects, just the same way. What happens is the author of the library will, in the target, encode the location of the library. For instance, it's the .so at that path. The include path for the library, which is where to find headers, and we can see the path that says, okay, the headers can be found here, and there could be multiple directories in this list. We can also encode dependencies. We say here, Qt widgets actually depends on Qt core and Qt GUI. So this is also saved as part of the target. We say, here are the compiler or the linker options that have to be used, like fpic, for instance. We say these are the processor definitions that should be used. For instance, Qt no debug or other defines that will be propagated this way from the library to the users of the library. Also the C++ language standard that should be used, these kind of things. All of this becomes part of the target, in this example, Qt 5 widgets. And by simply linking to this target, we benefit from all of these settings, the location of the library, the include path, and so on. And this is why in the previous video, when we were linking to Qt widgets, we didn't have to specify any of these things. They just came free as part of the target link libraries line. Let's have a look at the example again. What we said was find package Qt 5 and then target link libraries, and we link to Qt 5 widgets. And this is how we inherit from all of these settings, and they are used for linking hello world and also for compiling hello world when we're looking for headers. So this is kind of the magic of modern CMake. As the user of a library, it is extremely easy because all we have to do is target link libraries and it will import all of those settings automatically. We can use all of this in our own project as well. If we say I have a library called REST and it depends on the library HTTP, if I write target link library REST public HTTP, this means HTTP is a public dependency of my REST library. Anyone who links to the REST library should also link to the HTTP library, and this will happen automatically. This is typically used when the headers for the REST library use types that come from the HTTP library. So it makes no sense to use one library without the other. Then in my application, all I have to do is target link library and I link to the REST library and it will automatically link to HTTP as well. On the link line, we can see -l REST, -l HTTP. CMake has done the right thing, turned these dependencies into the actual link line that will be used to link the executable. For more information about CMake, we can deliver a 2-day training, either remotely or on site. In the next video, I will tell you a bit more about this training and what's in it. Thank you for watching this series.